I want to talk to you today about relationships. Oh my goodness. And I am no expert on this, don't get me wrong, but I'm learning a lot about me and relationships, and I'm learning a lot from other people. And I've had a friend recently who has fallen head over heels in love with someone, and she has been so amazing to talk to and you know, follow the journey of, and it's just been an incredible journey. And I don't know if, I'm sure everyone out there has been in that situation before, where they are head over heels in love and that crazy high 1 minute and completely low the next, and crying and laughing and wanting to spend all your time with that person and feeling that kind of ache inside, and how we deal with that, and how we deal with us, you know, whatever age you are, whether you're young in your teenage years, that's painful, and even when you're old like me, my 40s, love can hit you at any time, and actually it's a gift, but it's so difficult because nobody teaches you how to deal with it when you get it. And I kind of would go back to schools and think maybe it's something that schools should teach you, you know, how to handle those really heightened emotions and how to deal with it and how to, you know, how to play the game, you know, because there's a massive difference between a man and a woman, and a woman and a woman and a man and a man. There's always a polarity that creates that spark. There's a, you know, there has to be that polar opposite thing that makes you yearn for that person. And it's finding out how to deal with it. And we were learning a lot, you know, me and my friend about who about how men work and how women work and how the relationship gels and what to do and to not be too desperate and not be too, you know, too upset, but find a strategy that works. And we were coming up with things like, you know, don't make yourself too available, even in a relationship. And I really believe the best relationships are relationships where they're not comfortable. I know we all go for this comfortable, but actually the best feelings in the world is where you're pushing the boundaries, you're doing more, you're actually, you know, you're taking risks. And a relationship is a place where it's so unsafe because you've got somebody else that defines your happiness. And that's so difficult. Oh my God, it's the scariest thing, because what they do affects you. You know, you in work, you can decide whether you're going to be successful or not. Quite simple. You know, at home, you can decide if you're successful or not. But in a relationship, that other person has complete control over what you feel. So it's finding a way of taking control. And we were looking at some strategies for, especially for women, actually, because obviously I've got a better understanding of that, and how to deal with that kind of feeling of, you know, does he like me enough? Is he into me? All that kind of stuff. And we were looking at making sure that you don't give yourself too much. And women are very, very giving and really, you know, open people. And I've seen it all the time where women will give themselves so much and almost put the other person off, you know, put their partner off by being too much. And actually there's a real strength in being, not being aloof and different and pushing people away, but giving people a bit of, you know, what they can't have. Don't give yourself all to somebody. Give little bits to them and let them give little bits back to you, and enjoy the process. Enjoy that being in love rather than throw yourself in at the deep end and end up in a relationship where it just goes flat. And I've seen so many people that have, you know, fallen head over heels in love, but then just got comfortable and not continue to, you know, improve themselves, make themselves feel better, make themselves, you know, do things for the other person. It's kind of become like horse trading, you know, like, oh, if he does that, then I'll do that. Or, you know, she does, if he cleans the bathroom, oh, you know, I'll give him a kiss, whatever it is. But there's a lot of that goes on in relationships, and it's really sad, because at the beginning, if you think back to the beginning of those relationships, it wasn't about who did what for who. It was just because you wanted to be with that person, you would have given them anything. And it's just, there's this comfortable thing that comes in. And I don't know where it changes, but don't get comfortable. Keep yourself on a level where you're still improving yourself, because that's the most attractive thing. Not becoming, you know, a partnership. Be your own person within a relationship and make that the spark. That's how the spark stays. Be two separate people who come together and enjoy each other's company. But don't become one person, because you end up being flatmates. And oh my God, I know so many people who live together but aren't actually, you know, only doing it because the other one is there. You know, be there and actually stop putting something back into that relationship. Be be beautiful, be the best version of yourself, be, you know, put yourself on a pedestal, you know, so that person really wants you still, because that's the key. You know, it's not about being, you know, doing the right thing. It's about being the best version of yourself so you can give that to somebody else. Don't settle, is what I'm saying. Do not settle. Make yourself the best version of yourself, even in a relationship. And actually, there's three types of relationships. It always makes me laugh. And this is Tony Robbins, I think. The first type is absolute, unbelievable infatuation and love and that kind of spark and that kind of stuff, which everybody has felt at some point and everybody loves, but kind of is the most uncomfortable feeling ever. But it's magical. Then there's a middle level where you're kind of flatmates, you've been together for a while, you kind of horse trade, you kind of just, you know, I'll do this, you do that, and it's kind of when families happen as well. And then there's that bottom level, which is planning your escape. And oh my God, have I been in that situation so many times, planning my escape. And I'm never going to be there again because I'm not going to plan anymore. I'm just going to get out, because if you're planning your escape, you should be out. Don't plan your escape. Just go. Don't make it a second thought, because there's other people out there who are looking for someone like you. And, you know, you can't have Mr. Wrong in the house, because Mr. Right will never come along. So this is your only chance. You've only got a certain amount of time on this earth. Make sure you find that spark again, because it, as we know, it's the most incredible thing. And I honour you. You know who you are. And I think you're amazing. And keep going, because you're incredible. Anyway, take care. Bye.